Number 6. Sharks. Sharks have existed for 400 million years, and over that time have evolved with our oceans to be a vital predator at the top of the marine food web. Using their predatory prowess, something we've now vilified them for, sharks maintain a healthy fish population by weeding out the sick and the weak, allowing only the strongest to survive and cutting out the spread of disease. This is arguably the most important service they provide. As the biggest, baddest fish in the bath, it also falls on them to keep lesser predator populations in check. If sharks were to go extinct, these lesser predators would reproduce unopposed, leaving prey at risk of being overconsumed. So begins the chain reaction. Without prey, the leftover predators will die off themselves, and coral reefs fade away under blooms of algae. Herbivorous fish usually keep coral clean, but without them, algae can grow, greedily sucking out oxygen and suffocating the water. Number 5. Fungus. Maybe not the sort of fun guy you want at a party, but fungi are much more than the mold growing in that old yogurt pot in the fridge. Fungi are responsible for life on our planet as we know it today. Without them, we would not exist. They work as chemists far beyond the scope of the human race, producing molecules we have yet to replicate, even in a lab. Their ability to break down seemingly inedible organic matter and transform it into life-giving nutrients makes them gatekeepers of our nutrient cycles. Without them, we would face pileups of dead plant matter that would cover vast landscapes and bury forest floors. They don't just all remove waste, though. Yeast is a fungus, which has afforded humans the luxury of bread, beer, and wine for thousands of years. Very little is known about their biology, and best estimates suggest that only 5% of species have been discovered. Given how crucial that 5% is, it's best suggested we don't discover the true scope of their influence by wiping them out. Number 4. Ants. They have evolved with the planet from the time of the dinosaurs. And if humans are the drivers of this planet, then ants are the treads on its wheels that keep it on track. Their ability to organize and work in colonies of upwards of a million has led them to adapt into builders, pollinators, and effective predators across the world. There are estimated to be over a quadrillion or 1 million billion individual ants. And thank goodness for that, because without them, we'd have some dirty deeds to do. As decomposers, ants eat and deal with everything we don't want to, like organic waste, insects, and dead animals. Humans may preach reduce, reuse, recycle, but ants actually live it successfully. They recycle organic waste and nutrients back into the soil, which they in turn aerate by digging tunnels. Ant nests are biodiversity hotspots, as the colony patrols every millimeter of their territory, collecting and spreading nutrients. Along with properly dealing with waste, ants have figured out another problem humans have yet to solve: pest control. You may not like to see the Red Army march through your home, but ants are equally territorial and will keep the likes of termites, fleas, and ticks at bay for you. Whilst we humans may appear to be drunk at the wheel, the hypothetical disappearance of ants would cause collective environmental chaos. Plants and vegetation would stop growing in the now unaerated, imbalanced soil, affecting every animal species. And we mean all of them. Number 3. Bats. Even if you don't notice them, rest assured that of the 1,200 bat species, they're working hard as one of our real-life animal protectors. 70% of the world's bats feast on insects, eating up to 1,000 creepy crawlies an hour, providing a free and healthy alternative to harmful chemical pesticides, saving farmers across the globe billions of dollars in pest control, and our insides from at least some questionable insecticides. The stink of it is that even when they're pooping, bats are still doing their bit. Bat droppings, or guano, is a naturally occurring super fertilizer. Nitrogen phosphate and potassium-enriched seeds are spread throughout forests, in their attempt to restore the deforestation we as humans are so desperate to inflict. Guano really does sting the nostrils, but it should also be noted for its aid with the growth of flora, such as agave, which is vital as the base ingredient for tequila. Most plants require pollination to produce seeds, and as bats from the nectar-drinking family feed, they transfer pollen, germinating as they go. A healthy bat population is associated with a healthy ecosystem. If bats were to go extinct, then humans will certainly no longer get to enjoy a variety of foods, like avocados, bananas, cashews, mangoes, and cacao, to name a few. Bats are responsible for maintaining over 50% of the world's rainforests. And without these winged crusaders, jungles would decrease at an even more alarming rate. Insect plagues would have free range to ravage the planet, destroying crop after crop, whilst infections of deadly diseases such as malaria and yellow fever would rapidly increase. Would we survive without bats? Maybe, but you would soon miss their unquestionable impact on the biodiversity of the planet we inhabit. Number 2. Bees. Bees are a strong contender for being the most important animal species for the survival of the human race. As the human population continues to grow, so does its need for more food to feed everyone. One solution to this has been a marked increase in agricultural demand and crop growing, an industry carried on the tiny backs of the world's number one pollinators, the bee. They pollinate a third of the crops humans rely on, and the most interesting ones at that. Without bees, you can say goodbye to the plethora of fruits, vegetables, nuts, and seeds that you see lining our supermarkets today. There would be a marked decrease in productivity in at least 75% of worldwide crops that give us humans the variety of nutrients that we need to survive. Although technology has replaced the jobs of many, honeybees remain the invaluable masters of pollination. Honeybees contribute the equivalent of $30 billion to the economy in crops annually. And despite our best efforts, we as humans do not have the technology to fill that gap. As part of the base of many ecosystems, their death would, indirectly and directly, cause a devastating chain reaction affecting all levels of the food chain. If bees disappear, we may not die of famine, but the planet and our diet would be desolate. Number 1. Plankton. Phytoplankton, a subspecies of the plankton family, quite simply put, are the real lungs of the Earth. Rainforest conservation is crucial to human survival for future generations. But phytoplankton are responsible for two-thirds of the world's entire oxygen production right now. Plankton can be found in almost all sunlit bodies of water, from the frozen Arctic Circle to the hottest of hot springs. Phytoplankton absorb energy from the sun and take nutrients from the water for photosynthesis. These microscopic but mighty bacteria may only be less than 1% of the world's biomass, but they are producing over 66% of the oxygen the Earth requires to breathe easily, both literally and figuratively. Plankton, in their various forms, sit, or more accurately, drift around at the bottom of the marine food web. Their existence provides a base food source for marine life in salt or fresh water, from tiny bivalves to the largest of whales, making them a true keystone species. The smallest of fish would have to find an alternative food source, or most likely perish. The knock-on effect would be felt across the entire marine food web, including not only fish, but birds and many species of mammal. Homo sapiens are already responsible for overfishing of the seas. Would this be the final nail in the coffin? Yes, but it would come in different stages. Predators would wipe out prey mercilessly, and without a sustainable food source, the all-you-can-eat buffet would not last long. Apex predators would be all that remains, and eventually, they would have to starve or turn to cannibalism. Some coral and other sea life may survive, but soon these seemingly empty bodies of water would be nothing more than that. Over a longer period of time, the Earth's atmosphere would change, making it increasingly hard to breathe as O2 levels fall and CO2 levels rise. Thanks for watching. Would you rather be the last human left on Earth, or never be left completely alone ever again? Let us know in the comments below.